In some scenarios, you may have to transfer the source of authority of a user account which was originally created in Azure AD to on-premises Active Directory. Hello everyone, my name is Anshul and I'm a part of Azure Identity and Authentication team at Microsoft. This video is a quick demonstration to help understand the concept of soft match using UPN and SMTP address through which you can match two different users and transfer the source of authority to on-premises Active Directory. Before we begin, we need to ensure that the TerSync feature block soft match is set to false and enable soft match on UPN is set to true. In UPN match, we attempt to match two different user object information. A user in Azure AD, which has directory synchronization set to no, can be matched to an on-premises object with the same UPN. In this video, we have a user named Mark Stone, which is created in Azure AD, and we want to sync this user to another object in on-premises Active Directory using SoftMatch. We obtain the user principal name of this user, and after this, we go back to on-premises Active Directory and we create a new user with the same user principal name as that of the user in Azure Active Directory. Once we have created the user, we will go to PowerShell and force a Delta Sync cycle on the Azure AD Connect. Once the Delta Sync cycle on Azure AD Connect is completed, we go back to Azure Active Directory, refresh, and we can see that the user is now synchronized with on-premises Active Directory. Also notice that the display name of the user has been changed. It is same as that of the user in on-premises Active Directory since the source of authority is now on-premises AD. Another way to do a soft match is using primary SMTP address. In this case, we obtain the primary SMTP address of the user in Azure Active Directory. Another way to obtain the primary SMTP address is using the Exchange Admin Center. We need to make a note of this SMTP address. We go back to on-premises Active Directory. In this case, I have an existing user and I'll update the primary SMTP address of this user to same as that of the user present in Azure Active Directory. Once I've saved the changes for the user, we click OK. And now we can run a force Delta synchronization on Azure AD Connect. After the sync cycle has been completed, we can go back to Azure Active Directory and we will notice that the user status has changed to synchronized with on-premises Active Directory. Another thing to notice here is that the user principal name of the user has also been updated as that of the user in on-premises Active Directory. Few things to notice here is that the UPN gets changed to what is present in on-premises Active Directory as the object becomes directory synchronized. Incorrectly setting the wrong SMTP can cause negative impact in the environment. So be very cautious in doing any of the above changes and take necessary backups before performing any action. If your on-premises object is incorrectly synchronized with another Azure AD user, you would have to hard delete the incorrect cloud user and then perform a soft match between the correct Azure AD and on-premises user account. I hope this video is helpful. Thank you for watching.